Hey boys, hey girls. The dam will make a meatloaf, a Cajun style meatloaf. I noted other lights in your eyes. You reset light sensor. A good friend of mine's son was out cycling. I think he's in his 20s. And he was hit by a car. He was in ICU last week, and he's back home now, but his parents are taking care of him. And I'm going to make a meatloaf for their family and us too. I'm going to make two of them, actually. And we're going to send them a complete meal, you know, bread, veggie, potatoes, meatloaf. Yum. So let me get started. Alright, we got some yaya collards down here. I done washed and rinsed some fresh basil out of my garden. Got it right here. We're going to grind it up with this spice chopper. I got some garlic. We're going to press. I got some fratelli. Crushed tomatoes with basil and herbs and good things like that. Then we're going to get started with this here, assembling this meatloaf. Let me crush that garlic and whack up all them herbs. Alright, we got all the prep done. One whole bunch of green onions, two bell peppers, about five sticks of celery, a whole head of garlic, and a whole bunch of oregano. Got some bread in there. See that, Mr. Welling? We got some evap milk. Got a word of evap milk. Get it all worked up and in a frenzy. And yeah, I washed my damn hands with bleach. Open the shook up and worried evap milk. With a church key. Like that. Look, down in here. Pour it on your bread. And let it suck up some of that goodness. And this ain't no low-fat meal, no boy. Uh-uh. But you ain't gonna see this till after you eat. Let's go on down there, boy, and put these green onions on top of everything else. Boy, them smell good enough to eat just like that. And yeah, I washed all the damn vegetables with this all-natural veggie wash, fruit and veggie wash, safely removes waxes, chemicals, soil, and fingerprints. Anything else that may be on that. I said record, you stupid camera. Now mash that bread all about. And I can see, need a little bit more bread in here. So let me wrench my hands and get a couple more pieces. Because you don't want this to be too moist. Two more pieces added. And this filler makes this better, yeah boy. Gotta have some of that bread in there. Adds a little sweetness to this. And some moisture from that evap milk. Do you put eggs in here? I don't. Don't need them. We got the evap milk for moisture. I got 3 pounds of ground round. Now let's start layering this stuff in here. Mix this about somewhat. And put you a layer. you a layer of that stuff too. Get you some of the garlic, chunk it in there, some of your oregano's, and they knows, and some salt and pepper. That was 2.5 pounds, two and a quarter pounds, I'm sorry. Another layer. Grab some of that bread mixture, put it on top. We're gonna have to mix all this up, yeah boy. Get you some more garlics, chunk it on there. Some more of these vegetables, chunk them on there. Some more of these rounded up herbs, chunk them on there. Am I leaving anything out? I don't think so. One more pound. Look, the diaper came off. We don't want the diaper. The rest of your herbs. More salt and pepper. Mm-hmm. The rest of your grounded up garlics. Now you're going to have to wear this up. Mix it all about. Put it all in there, JB. Don't be shy. Even though he is a lawyer, he ain't gonna die. Let me mix all this up. With clean hands, boy. Now let's go on and form us a meatloaf. Got all that word in there. I've never made this much before, so I hope it's got enough salt and pepper in it. But you ain't gonna know till the next day. You ain't gonna see this video for a couple days. You'll have eat it by then. Look, I got a pan over here. I'm gonna put the meat in. Form a loaf. This way, boy. This way. Uh-huh. This gotta feed about a bunch of people. We got a lot of people gonna be eating at his house. And he gonna cry. Look, I'll put you in some sulfur leftovers, Weldon. Now. And this is going to shrink. Can you see over here, boy? This is going to shrink up once it's baked off in the oven. One nice, well-formed loaf. The vegetables also going to release some water, a liquid into this to keep it moist. And the reason I don't like putting eggs in it is because it makes it tough. We ain't making no goddamn quiche, boy. Come on. Now. Well-formed meatloaf. So is you done? Oh, hell no. We gotta put some bacon on the meatloaf. That's gonna baste it. Or help it baste. While it's cooking. So we got some hardwood smoked bacon. And we're going to watch him. I'm going to show you when I'm done. There you go. All seasoned up with that smoked bacon. And we're going to put them in the oven. 350. Till it's ready. Or done internal. It's going to take about an hour and a half. Hey, dumb camera. Glad you're recording this time. Now I'm going to go ahead and take the luxury of sticking the probe in the smallest meatloaf, because it's going to get cooked first. Paying attention there, boy. And set the probe for desired cook temp. The larger one is going to take a little bit longer. We'll remove it and stick it in the larger one after the smaller one comes up to 155. Imagine that. That oven over there, that smart ass oven, you got a place to stick a probe in it. Then you can set the probe temp, then set the oven temp. Ooh, it's like building nuclear submarines and shit, huh? Especially since I'm cooking for my friends, I want to make sure it's done. And he's a lawyer, too. And I won't get sued. But if you eat too much, that ain't my problem, no boy. Oh, let me tell y'all this, too. You can also stuff the meatloaf with hard-boiled eggs. Raw asparagus washed first, cheese, anything you want, man. We put a stick of andouille inside of it. So we got some aluminum foil in a pan. Let's go on and put the rest of this pound of bacon in there. Like that. Separate it out and bake this off in the same oven. What's that for, JB? You're going to see, JB. Go bake that off in that same oven that the meatloaf is in. And that hardwood smoke is going to rise up into that meatloaf. And yeah, I know you can do it in the smoker. You can actually put it on a barbecue pit and cook your meatloaf. I hadn't tried it, so I can't say for sure, but the pictures that I've seen of other friends that have done it looks dry. When they slice it, it's dry. Looks like a dry hunk of meatloaf. Mine comes out juicy. All right, so I got some B-sized potatoes, which is what we use to what we use in boiled crawfish or shrimp or crab or whatever you want, how you call them. I'm going to put them in here and rinse them and drain the water and parboil them to get them started for this. Are you paying attention down here? Do put some salt in the water, yeah boy. Let's pour some beautiful bacon grease down in there. See right there? Now let's chunk us some whack-up onions in there. Like that. And go saute them in the bacon grease. Yum. One number 8 can, I think is the way it's called. 6 pounds, 5 ounces. Blue Lake fancy cut green beans. I wish I had a big one of the Allen's brand, but I don't. Send me one Allen's or a case. So, let's see if this Hamilton Beach can opener can handle this big dog. Yeah. See like that right there? Damn good. This 6 pound can open. Alright, it's vacuum sealed, so I gotta release the vacuum. Church key. Oh yeah, works well. And pour this big can of them greens and string beans in that. It worried him some. We don't want to cook them to mush. All we got to do is warm them through. We're going to put some potatoes in there. See that bacon over there? That going in there too. So here we go. We got this stuff ready for our friends, and we serving them up a nice big plate of it. Mini Pop's down. We've got some of this stuff right here. Yum. Green peas, bacon, potatoes. I hope I'll leave enough for Miss JB. Eat. If not, tough. And we've got this meatloaf. Yum, boy. Look all that bacon crisp up on top. Let's slice some of that up. There how one slice look. There how two slices look. We gotta get some of that gravy on top of it. Just throw it on there, boy. Who cares? See like that? Yum. You see the little piece of bacon right there? Jump in my mouth. Yum. Yum. Yum.